Are you struggling with formatting your gross descriptions in a clear and concise manner that's easy to read? In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use the Raymond paragraph system to do just that. Coming up. So the idea for this video is based on a paper called Raymond's paragraph system, which details a non-traditional way of organizing your gross. Traditionally, your gross is going to be one long paragraph that still contains all the relevant information, but might be a little bit easy or less easy to read. Imagine giving a presentation in which all of your notes or your speech is on one sheet of paper, it's single spaced, and there's no new paragraphs. Versus the Raymond system, where your contents for your gross are broken down into multiple paragraphs, with each paragraph containing a specific set of contents. This is more like giving a speech on cue cards that's double spaced, easy to read and easy to flip through. Now the Raymond system is broken down into five specific paragraphs. The first paragraph contents are the specimen contents. Second is your primary pathology. Third is secondary pathology, followed by inking code in the fourth, and then finally your blocking or section code. We're going to dive in and take a closer look at each of these different paragraphs. So first paragraph is going to be the specimen elements or specimen contents. This is what you actually receive as a specimen on your bench. Now you're going to detail what the actual specimen includes. You're also going to include measurements and weights. And when you're dictating these, you're going to try and at least avoid saying measuring or weighing, and instead you're going to put those descriptors in brackets. So instead of saying specimen consists of an ovary weighing 52 grams and measuring 10 by 8 by 6 centimeters, you would say something like specimen consists of an ovary, bracket 52 grams, comma 10 by 8 by 6 centimeters, bracket. So it breaks up the measurements and makes it easier for the pathologist to pull those out of your report. Another time-saving tip for this portion of the report is if you look at a portion of the specimen and it looks unremarkable, you will describe it as unremarkable. You don't need to list it as tan, smooth and glistening, or any of those descriptors which basically mean unremarkable. Now, this of course means that you're going to need a bit more experience in knowing what unremarkable actually looks like. We don't want to be calling pathology unremarkable, so if you're very new to grossing, or if you're being trained, it might be worth your time to still describe the outer surface as tan, smooth, and glistening, or whatever applies to that specific specimen. But as you get more and more experience, you can move towards using the term unremarkable. And once you do, you're done with that portion of the tissue and you don't need to mention it again. And then after that, in second paragraph, is the primary pathology. This is going to typically be the reason why the specimen was removed and should, in most cases, support the clinical history. If the requisition says breast cancer, you should typically receive a breast specimen with a mass in it. And here you're also looking to describe the sort of color, consistency, and texture of the tumor, basically painting a mental picture for whoever reads the report of what it looks like. Here you're also describing the extent of the disease in relation to any other relevant anatomical landmarks. So this is where you can mention distance to margins, depth of invasion, or any other, again, structures that are present. And while this typically works for a solitary lesion, imagine a single mass in a breast, this also works for more diffuse processes like inflammatory bowel disease. Now, ideally, most of the time, the clinical history should match with the primary pathology that you're seeing. However, if there's some inconsistency here, like a gallbladder removed for stones and you find an incidental carcinoma within the gallbladder, this still works in that situation. Your third paragraph is going to be the secondary pathology. These are things incidental or not sort of the main focus of the actual specimen. If you have a colon cancer, for example, and there are diverticuli or incidental polyps also found, or even lymph nodes, this is a good place to stick that information. And in some cases, if there's no secondary pathology present, again, if there's no diverticuli or polyps or lymph nodes in that colon specimen, if there was any type of special studies done, like tissue taken for flow cytometry, or if there was tumor banking done, this is a good place to mention that as well. And that's followed up in our fourth paragraph with the inking code. Now, some specific things to remember about the inking code. It's recommended to do this line by line. So for each color is going to get its own line. And then first we want to say the color, then followed by what it represents. It'll just make it easier for the pathologist to pick that color out and then read across. And then following that, in our fifth paragraph is going to be the section or the blocking code. Now, like the inking code, we're going to have one cassette or one set of cassettes per line. And we're also going to list the cassette number first, followed by its contents. So for example, it would be A1 proximal margin, or A1 to A2 proximal margin. The next line, A3 distal margin, instead of proximal margin in A1-A2. That would be an incorrect way of formatting it. and something to consider for larger, more complicated specimens which are generating a lot of blocks, it's a good idea to make sure that your blocking kind of matches up with the order of your growth. So when you start with your primary pathology and then move to secondary pathology, it's a good idea if your blocking focuses first on the primary pathology areas and then moves on to the second pathology as you get more towards the end. And then a point that isn't specifically mentioned in this Raymond's paragraph system, but I think is a good idea to do, is at the very start of your blocking code, if you just mention representative sections or tissue submitted in total or some variation of that, that'll just indicate to the pathologist or whoever is reading your report or if there is still leftover tissue or if they're looking at all the tissue that was submitted. Now, the application of this system is generally designed sort of best for large specimens that are complex and generating a lot of blocks. Typically, if there's orientation that requires inking and again a lot of blocks are being generated, this works very well for that type of specimen, and we'll see that usually with cancer resections, but you can still use it for benign specimens like a fibroid uterus. Now, any new system is going to have its own little bumps or challenges along the way, and some of them that I think you might run into is if you were trained to gross and dictate as you dissect. This is typically done sort of from the outside in. You may spend a lot more time on secondary or unremarkable findings before you actually move to the primary pathology. So the Raymond system actually requires that you do some dissection work first and then go back and do the grossing, because if there's a tumor on the inside of something like a colon, you have to open the colon, do your dissection, and then you can measure things, two margins, depth of invasion, and mention relevant anatomical structures after that. And as a result, this may slow down your grossing and dictations at first, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. You're learning a new system, you may want to make sure that you still capture all the relevant information, but if you work at a very busy site, you may start to feel a bit of a time pressure on yourself. So in those cases, I would recommend maybe tackle one or two cases a day with this new system until you get more used to it, and then you can increase your speed and your usage of it throughout the workday. Another challenge that you might run into is getting just a little bit of pushback from transcription or staff pathologists, especially if you're working at a site where they are very accustomed to reading the kind of very traditional gross descriptions that are one long paragraph. I think as long as you communicate with them what you're trying to do, you're trying to make a report that's easier for them to read, it should work out well in the end. And from here, if you are looking for any extra resources, the actual paper that I was talking about in this video, I'm just going to stick it down in the link below. You can click through to there to actually see how they lay out using Raymond's paragraph system. Some other resources that I could recommend are just looking through the Lester's or Westra Surgical Dissection books. They offer some good insight on what sort of relevant grossing dictations should sound like. I think Lester's is probably the most comprehensive out of those two, and Raymond's takes things from Lester's and sort of changes the formatting just a little bit to make it a bit more concise and laid out a bit easier just for reading for pathologists. But at the end of the day, I think both are great resources if you're looking for some extra help. And if these tips helped you, please let me know in the comments below, and I'll catch you next time.